All the lushness of the butter is what you taste. This is called a Benne Masala Dosa for the right reasons. I want to bathe my Rava Idli with that chutney and taste it.
We are in Malleswaram in northwest Bengaluru today, and we are here to savour a meal at an establishment that's not just a pit stop that provides mere sustenance, but an institution that's much loved by the people of Bengaluru. We are at Shri Sagar or CTR here in Malleswaram, an establishment that's been around for the last 70 years, that's found much favour for its Benne Masala Dosa. In fact, when we did our dosa trail, we also explored this in that episode. I'm going to place a link to that episode in the description below and also somewhere up here. But today, I'm looking forward to savouring the dosa, of course, plus also the other snacks, the other tiffin, the other tindi that's on offer here at CTR on any given evening. So let's go in and check out what tiffin CTR style is all about. Let's go.
Well, walking into CTR or Shri Sagar is like stepping back in time, because that's the look, that's the feel that one gets when one looks around. Right from the old antique clock there to the frames that have probably been hanging out here for the last few decades, it literally is a step back into the good old days of Bengaluru. That's the sense, that's the aura that one gets when one enters this space. And that's the menu for the evening, and I'm looking forward to tasting as many of those dishes that we can. The eatery opened barely 15 minutes ago, and already every table is taken. That's the appeal, that's the draw of CTR.
My and my father is coming from 20-25 years here.
Here, and what do you eat every time?
Dosa.
Masala dosa.
Masala dosa, Mangalore bajji.
And Mangalore bajji.
Famous.
Yeah, you've been coming for the last 25 years. Lovely. So I'm here with Mr. Sandesh Pujari, who's the third generation, in a manner of speaking, at CTR, right? Of course, he's manning the till here at a very busy time. Every table is taken, but I'm told this is not the busiest the CTR gets. It gets a lot more busier. And today is not a weekend, so we've come on a day when we can hopefully have a conversation. So when did CTR begin?
It started in 1952 by Ramakrishna Holda.
Okay.
My dad, Mr. Sanjay Pujari, he took over some 1980s.
Okay. And so when it comes to CTR, I think CTR is much loved for its dosa. What makes it so special?
Yes, it includes the quantity, the quality, and definitely the taste quality. We do have the same recipe what we are doing since.
But you know what, all that talk of the dosa, the bajji that the customer was talking about has got my taste buds going. I definitely want to get to the table soon, but before that, can we take a look at the kitchen?
Sure,
and watch the dosa being made?
Sure.
So is it a typical taste or a typical bite or a typical texture that you get out of a CTR Benne Masala Dosa?
Put the dosa in such a way that it's crispy.
Crispy.
Crispy, and on the other side it's little thick.
So you basically bite into that dosa, literally.
Yes.
Oh, there's some benne going.
That's the butter.
That's the butter. So this is again butter that comes from the villages?
Villages, yes.
So the butter, of course, in a Benne Masala Dosa is very, very important. And so there's tons of butter that goes onto the Benne Masala Dosa.
Everything is on the same size, thickness here, and you could see the crispiness coming like that.
You know, that's very interesting. What I've just learned from Sandesh is an interesting fact of the dosa here, which makes it so popular, is the fact that when the dosa is poured, when the batter is poured, it's poured in a swirl. So you have thick edges and you have thin edges. So,
yes.
So the thin part gets roasted nicely,
roasted,
and that
becomes
crisp and kadak.
Exactly.
And the one that's slightly thicker becomes soft and fluffy. And then, of course, the palya. Oh, I love the texture of the palya. That palya is almost like a mousse. It's so soft and creamy. And of course, there's probably a fair bit of turmeric that goes into it.
Yes, definitely.
And there's some coriander.
Coriander, onions.
Onions. So do you use garlic as well in your...
No, we don't use garlic.
So how many dosas are made here on a given day?
We don't count, but at a time we'll put somewhere like 60 dosas in 4 minutes.
Yeah, so if you do 60 dosas in 4 minutes and the establishment's open for about 5 or 6 hours, you can calculate the thousands of dosas that probably get dished out of the CTR kitchen. And you were telling me this is the first dosa stone. This is where it was first made.
This is the place and this is the exact stone which has been using from almost 40 years.
For 40 years. So there is probably a certain Benne Masala Dosa energy here. Oh, look at that. That is crisp. So between the Benne Masala Dosa and the regular Masala Dosa, which is your preferred choice?
I definitely offer butter masala.
Yeah.
People who are like little health conscious, they're good for a regular masala.
Okay, so that comes with the kempu chutney inside.
Kempu chutney. We do put kempu chutney for this also, only if the customer demands.
Alright, so if you like it spicy and you still want to taste the Benne Masala Dosa, ask them for the kempu chutney.
Yes.
So that basically is some red chilies.
Red chilies, yes.
Alright. And then these are served with two chutneys there.
Yeah, one is regular coconut chutney and other will be the coriander chutney.
I love the size of these dosas. There's a sort of dosas that make for the perfect snack. And this is the same size in morning as well.
Yeah.
They have to fit into that groove here. So the dosa master has to make the same size of dosa. So this is the banda, the batter. How long is it fermented?
2-3 hours.
Alright, and what would typically go into it?
Dal, rice.
But what is the X factor in that? What is that?
Different things, not very secret.
But I think what really matters is the technique. I think the fact that they're doing 60 dosas in 4 minutes. No, they're focused on the dosas that they are making here. The people who've been making your dosas, have they been making it for years?
They have been making it for almost 35 years.
35 years. Wow, so that's 35 years of just making the dosa.
Dosa.
And so you have dosa masters who are focused only on dosa making.
Only on dosa.
Wow, that's commitment to a craft. So in addition to the masala dosa, what are the other dosas that are popular?
Set dosa. We do make kali dosa in the morning and evening it's available only for 1 hour. Set dosa will be very soft.
Okay.
So it's given with sagu.
So this is a set dosa batter. So how different is the set dosa batter from that?
It just differs with the thickness, that's it.
Oh, the masala dosa batter is thicker?
That's thicker, yes.
Okay, and this is thinner.
This is a Rava Idli.
Okay. I love that carrot on top. The Rava Idli is served only in the evening?
Only in the evening, yes.
And of course, there's some GOLI BAJJI, or the Mangalore BAJJI.
Mangalore BAJJI.
And some Maddur Vade as well. Oh, nice. Now the GOLI BAJJI is a Mangalore South Canara snack,
yes.
Right? So it's been at the hotel right from the early days or it's something that you guys introduced?
We introduced like 30 years ago. Before that it was not there.
What makes for a good GOLI BAJJI?
Again the quality and the quantity.
There's a lot of yogurt that goes into that batter,
yes,
right?
Yes.
It's yogurt, it's rice flour, it's
rice
maida.
Maida.
Of course, yes. Mostly. Coconut, you put grated coconut?
Yeah.
Okay. You can tell how popular this Mangalore Bhaji or the GOLI Bhaji is. Look at the amount of batter that he has. This will get over in the evening.
This will get over in another 2 hours.
In another 2 hours.
2-3 hours.
I love the way those GOLI Bhajis are dancing away in that oil. I can't wait for them to be ready and taste some of the bhaji. Can we taste the bhaji right here?
Sure.
The way the food tastes, when you just take it out of the fire a few seconds, and even 5 minutes later, there is a difference.
Yes.
In terms of the way you taste it. So that's the reason why I like to taste wherever possible, not always of course, straight off the stove. Like we will hopefully do with this GOLI BAJJI. That bhaji is glistening away, even as he takes it off the oil. That bhaji will be hot and if we go for it, I think we'll burn our tongue, but we'll probably wait for it to cool, just maybe a few seconds. Busy, busy, GOLI BAJJI, oh, it's hot. Busy there, busy there. I love that crunch. That GOLI BAJJI pulls on the bite. It's crunchy and yet there's a certain stretchiness to it. You know, which I think is the hallmark of a good GOLI BAJJI. So it has a crisp, it has a crunch and that stretch and that soft, airy, porous inside, which is what makes for a good GOLI BAJJI. So I can also taste some cumin there. It's probably also some curry leaves that go into it, some chili as well. I'm going to dunk it into that chutney and go for it. There's always something very special about eating food, just off the stove. Thank you very much. Thank you.
This is Kesari Bath.
Kesari Bath. So is that available through the day?
Yes.
Do you also put some saffron in this?
A little bit of saffron.
That goes. You can look at the ghee that's floating on top of this kesari bhat. It gives you a sense of how rich this dish is. I'm definitely going to be tasting this before I leave. You can also see some raisins in there.
Vegetable sagu.
So this is a sagu that is served with a set dosa.
Set dosa.
Rava idli. It's almost a little reddish in color.
Yes.
So is it because of the chili, tomato?
Red chilies.
Red chili.
Yes.
What chili do you use in your sagu?
That bad ghee.
Bad ghee chili. And there's some vegetables in that as well.
Yes, more of vegetables.
Okay. This is a nutritious, a thick sagu. Where there's some
green peas, onions, tomatoes, and potatoes.
Oh, lovely.
Carrot.
Well, the kitchen is firing on all cylinders here. You've got dosas that are happening by the dozens, the goli bajji as well. The Maddur Vade is already ready. There's some rava idli steaming away out there, and there's some kesari bhat waiting to be savored. I can't wait to go to the restaurant and taste some of that busy tiffin here at CTR, Shri Sagar. Let's go. We've just emerged from the kitchen, and the place that was crowded when we went into the kitchen is even more crowded. So we're just waiting for a table. Always an indication of a good place. When you have to wait. If people are waiting for the food, you know there is something to the fare there. So when you go to a restaurant, you see people waiting, wait patiently, because you'll be rewarded with some great food, because that's what everybody is waiting for. I think we've spotted a table. ಒಂದು ಮಂಗಳೂರು ಬಜ್ಜಿ ಕೊಡಿ, ಒಂದು ಮದ್ದೂರು ವಡೆ ಕೊಡಿ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ರವೆ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡಿ. ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಮಾಡೋಣ. We have two of our dishes here. The goli bajji is getting ready. We just saw a batch of goli bajji is getting ready, but they're already sold out of that. So they have a fresh batch happening. And that was only a few minutes ago. So you know how popular those are. So out here, I have the Maddur Vade, which is basically a fritter that's made of some maida. There's some rice flour that goes into it. And of course, the chilies, the onions. And this traditionally comes from a place called Maddur. In fact, when I was doing a highway episode, when we were traveling on the Bengaluru-Mysuru highway, we did visit Maddur and tasted the Maddur Vade there as well. So I'm going to put a link to that video in the description below and also up here. And then we have the Rava Idli, which is served only in the evenings here at CTR. I think I'm going to make a beginning with that Rava Idli. It's hot. You can see some chili there. There's some coconut flecks that you can see in the Rava Idli as well. And I can't wait to commence my meal here at CTR with that Rava Idli. I want to taste that Rava Idli first just by itself. You can also see some curry leaf there. When you're eating in this part of the country, there always has to be curry leaf in your meal. And so comforting on the palate. I want to take that Rava Idli and dunk it into that chutney. I love the crunch of the coconut in that Rava Idli. I think I'm going to use my spoon to go for a perfect dunk of that Rava Idli into the chutney. I want to bathe my Rava Idli with that chutney and taste it. That's a fresh chutney. You can taste the freshness of the coconut in there. The spice that comes from the green chili. There's also some mustard seeds that's gone into the seasoning here. It's a delicious chutney. It's not a ghatti chutney, so it's easier to use a spoon when you're dunking your Rava Idli in the chutney. But there's nothing like eating with one's hands. And that's what I'm attempting to do with this Rava Idli and chutney combo. I love the grainy texture of the Rava Idli. There's plenty of curd that goes into the Rava Idli, so it's packed with nutrition. And it's steamed, so it's the healthiest snack that you can have. I'm going to taste it next with that sagu that is served as a combo with the Rava Idli. Some peas in there, some sort of a cucumber, I'm not very sure. Plenty of onions, I think there's some tomato that goes into it. That's a flavorful sagu. And what you want to do is place the Rava Idli in the sagu and bathe it literally with all that sagu. You want to make sure that you drench that Rava Idli with that sagu. That's such a comforting bite. I'm definitely tasting some cucumbers or some gourds in there. So you're tasting that nourishing bite of that gourd and also some of that skin. So there's also that fiber that's there in this sagu. So this is a sagu that's packed dense with nutrition. And taste. The Mangalore bajji has also arrived here. But before I get to the Mangalore bajji, I want to have another bite of that Rava Idli. And this time, with not just the sagu and also get some of that chutney. That kai chutney naped onto my rava idli to make for that perfect bite of that rava idli here at CTR. So I've got the rava idli, I've got the sagu and also that chutney. I love the enduring, comforting bite of that rava idli. There's the gentle, grainy texture of the rava idli, the bite of the coconut flakes, a little flavoring that comes from the curry leaves, and then the goodness of the vegetables that have gone into that vegetable sagu, and that slight heat from that chutney. Oh, that's delicious. When you come here, definitely ask for extra sagu. That sagu is certainly as good as that. I think I'm going to wait quickly, go to this Goli Bajji. Oh, it's hot. You can see that steam escape from that Goli Bajji. It's as hot as that. Hot off the oil. I know I'm going to burn my tongue, but there is something to eating hot food. Also love the way it's been speckled with that green chili. So you'll also get a tingle of heat in this bite. There is that crunch and that stretchy texture of that Goli Bajji. And it's soft, porous, airy inside. I can taste that tingling prick of the green chili that went into that bite. I can taste it on the tip of my tongue. And there definitely is more than a bit of chili that goes into this Goli Bajji. Just to kind of warm the palate, in a manner of speaking. And if you like it a little more spirited, dunk that Goli Bajji into that chutney. And go for it. There's also some lentils that goes into the chutney, and you can definitely taste that texture, that grainy texture, the grainy coarseness of the lentils along with the coconut. Love that chutney. The way to savor the Goli Bajji here is to dunk it nicely into that chutney and taste it. I love that subtle glint of sweetness that also emerges in the palate as you finish tasting that Goli Bajji. There's a bit of sugar that goes into it as well. I love the way the Goli Bajji pulls as you attempt to break it. This is the perfect Goli Bajji. It's got that perfectly scrumptious cooked exterior and that soft porous inside. You can see it's steaming away. It's as hot, it's as fresh as that. I love that crunch. Go for some more of that Goli Bajji and chutney. There's also some coconut in that Goli Bajji, and I just bit into some coconut shards. When you come to CTR, the Goli Bajji is certainly something that you should get. And for this, you got to come in the evening, because that's when they serve the Goli Bajji. And next, it's time to taste the Maddur Vade. It's got the texture of a cookie. And breaks also like a flaky cookie of sorts. This Maddur Vade is generously speckled with some onions. I can see some coriander, perhaps some chili that goes into it as well. Although it's deep fried, there's barely any oil that you feel on your fingers. I love the savory bite of this Maddur Vade. And what really lends flavor to this Maddur Vade are the onions, the fried onions. As soon as you place that Maddur Vade in your mouth, fried onion flavor envelops your palate. So traditionally this is made with some maida, made with some rice rava. I can also see, I think there's some peanuts that are also placed in the batter, and I just lost my peanut. This is a sort of snack that you can carry, that you can take home with you. Because I'm told this keeps for a few days. Next, I'm going to taste this crisp Maddur Vade with that chutney. Dunk it into that chutney. Give it a nice bath of sorts. So if you're expecting to taste a typical vade, for those who don't know the Maddur Vade is not that. The Maddur Vade, think of a crisp, savory biscuit, a flaky one at that, and that's what the Maddur Vade is all about. Garnish with fried onions, with some cumin, some curry leaves, and also some chilies. I think this chutney makes for the perfect accompaniment to all the dishes. It has a liquidy sort of a texture which helps in naping the chutney over whatever you want to taste it with. And once the chutney gets on board, it stays there till you place it in your mouth. That chutney certainly makes for a spirited companion to all that you taste here. I love that grainy bite of the coconut, that texture of the lentils and the spice of the chili, the seasoning of the mustard seeds that go into it. It's a delicious chutney. Now that we've done with the idli, the rava idli, the Maddur Vade and the Goli Bajji, time to place our next orders.
Puri, Benne Masala.
Puri otti ke ide?
Sagu chutney.
Same, now sagu chutney taste madideve.
Haudu, ade same.
Ade sagu chutney. Mane dosa alli?
Dosa alli Benne Masala. Benne plain, sad dosa, ordinary masala, kesari baatide.
Ondu Benne Masala taste madana.
Okay.
Ondu
ordinary masala.
Ordinary masala. So we've just ordered for our dosa here. I've ordered for the Benne Masala Dosa, of course, which is the holy grail when it comes to CTR, and also the plain masala dosa. He also recommended the set dosa, which is also much liked here, but I've tasted the set dosa earlier in the dosa trail episode. You will find a link to that episode in the description. But for now, we're gonna wait for the masala dosa, both Benne and ordinary. So there are two dosas here. So this is the plain masala dosa and this is the Benne masala dosa. The difference is that this is smothered in Benne, all that Benne that we saw, and this is made in oil, refined oil. And the other difference, this has got a bit of a kempu chutney that's inside that dosa, which I think makes it spicier. So typically the Benne masala dosa is not served with a kemp chutney unless the customer specifically asks for it. So I guess when it comes to the Benne masala dosa, they want the buttery flavor of the dosa to take prominence, to dominate all else on your palate. But not so in the case of the plain masala dosa or the regular masala dosa that they call it. And you can also see some of the chutney peep out on top of the dosa here. You can see some red right here. Color wise, they look very similar. This of course looks a little reddish brown, and this is more of that golden brown that you have come to expect out of the Benne masala dosa here. Let's go for the plain masala dosa first. Oh, this dosa is kadak. You literally break into it. Break into it all the way in the center. Get some of that dosa. So you get that dosa, you get the palya, and of course that kempu chutney. I tasted the plain dosa first because I didn't want the Benne dosa to influence the flavors of this plain dosa. I love that crunch of the dosa here at CTR. This dosa is cooked to that perfect crispness. You can see that almost translucent texture of that dosa. You can see the crispy bit, which is the most transparent, and then you have the thick, the soft, fluffy part of that dosa. This dosa is cooked to textbook perfection, CTR style. There's a certain sweetness to that batter. Very mellow, very gentle. It's got a bit of tartness and a bit of that sweetness. And that's the kempu chutney. There's basically some chili. You can taste the chili heat, but not very aggressive. And some coconut. I think that's what goes into that. I'm going to go for another bite of that dosa. It's quite thick in certain parts. So it's basically a combination between the thin, crispy texture and the softer, slightly thicker, fluffier part of the dosa. Get some of that palya. I love the mellow flavors of the potato. The potatoes are almost creamy, cooked to a near paste, and seasoned just perfectly. I'm going to get the bit of the palya and some of that kempu chutney in this bite. That palya barely whispers its flavors. Of course, there's some turmeric that's gone into it. There's some onions as well that you taste on the bite, some coriander. It basically allows for the crunch, the texture, the crispness, the bite of that dosa to take center stage. That's really what you're tasting. The palya plays a beautiful supporting act to that dosa here. The dosa here is served not just with the coconut chutney but also with a mint chutney. I think what I'm going to do before I taste the chutneys is taste the flavor of my Benne masala dosa. So I think those chutneys will probably take away from the flavor of the butter here. So I'm going to taste the Benne masala dosa before I dig into those chutneys. You can almost hear the crackle of that dosa. This dosa has been drenched in butter as it's been cooking, and you can see all of that ooze out as you tear into that dosa. This certainly is a dosa that's laden with butter, and you can see it glisten away on the dosa and even on your fingers. All the lushness of the butter is what you taste. This is called a Benne Masala Dosa for the right reasons. Then its name begins with a Benne, and that's the first thing that you taste. That homemade butter that is sourced from a village in Karnataka. Because they say that's where they get the best milk that goes into the making of the butter. Well, do they taste differently? Well, certainly. I find that the plain masala dosa is a little more crisper. It's probably a little more tougher on the bite. I think that's the character of the fact that it's cooked in oil. So definitely is crisped to a certain hardness, if you know what I mean. And that's what you taste when you bite. So definitely is a lot more kadak when it comes to that crispness. But when it comes to this Benne masala dosa here, it is crisp, it is crunchy, but not as crunchy as a plain masala dosa. That's because of the butter that it's cooked in. I think that butter also tames some of that kadak character of that dosa. I love the gentle flavors of this Benne masala dosa. If I were to return back to CTR, I'll definitely go for the Benne masala dosa again. There's nothing wrong in the plain masala dosa at all, but it's just the lush flavors of that butter, of that Benne, which is what makes it seriously addictive. And I'm told that people who come here need at least two or three of these dosas. And the good thing is the size of these dosas. This certainly is a dosa that you can eat at least two or three of without any problems. And now to taste the dosa with the chutney. There's also a certain smokiness to that coconut chutney that comes from the lentils, I think. Look at all that butter ooze out of this dosa. Oh, I'm gonna go for a generous piece of the dosa with that palya. Dunk it into that chutney. That crisp texture of the dosa, the mellow flavors of the palya, and the fresh bite of that coconut chutney. All swathed in the goodness of that butter. Oh, that's delicious. Taste some of the Benne masala now with the pudina chutney or the mint chutney. So I think there's mint in it, some coriander, and of course the coconut. Certainly it's a spicier chutney, and you can taste the freshness of the mint in that. So the way to eat a dosa here is to every now and then just savor the dosa just by itself, relish all those buttery notes. At times, tear away at the dosa, get some of that palya into it, savor the gentle tempering of that aloo gatte palya, and at times, go for the dosa, the masala, and the chutney, which will make for one big flavorful bite. If you want Benne masala heaven, this is where you have to be at CTR. This is delicious. Kesari bar taste madana, amale coffee. Puri next time again. He says there's some puri as well. But I think I've reached that stage. So I've got full lagi dega. We'll come back for the puri. I was just talking to Sharad, who's been coming here for the last 25 years. He says the flavor, the taste remains the same in all these years. The place has changed a bit. Chairs have changed. Perhaps the tables have changed. But the flavor, the taste hasn't changed. I think that's testament to the consistency of the fare that's served here. On that note, I can't wait to get to our Kesari bath here that's glistening away with some of that ghee. You can see some of that ghee. Leave the Kesari bath on the side, but I'm not going to let that happen. I'm going to go for that Kesari bath right away. This seems like a manageable portion, and I think that's a good thing about most of the dishes that you taste here. They all serve you in manageable portions, whether it's the dosa, whether it's the idli, or let's say the goli bajji, they all serve you in manageable portions. So it definitely feels like you can indulge in it without really weighing down on your tummy. And this Kesari bath seems just that. Of course, most people wouldn't be coming here and tasting six or seven dishes like I've tasted, but then that's what we've got to do. Oh, this Kesari bath is glistening away with all that ghee. I love the fact that it's topped with some cashews, some raisins. Can't wait to taste this. I love that ghee-laden, rich mouthfeel of the Kesari bath. You place it in your mouth, and it magically almost disappears. Oh, that's delicious. Just the right amount of sugar as well. Then there's some cardamom, so you have the gentle flavors of cardamom. Let's taste this Kesari bath now with the cashew
and also some of that raisin. That cashew too has been softened by that ghee, and that raisin provides that pop of sweetness. I love the graininess to this kesari bhat. And it's a perfect way to round up the tiffin experience here at CTR. My coffee is here, but I think I'm going to go for the last bite of my kesari bhat before I wind up my meal here with that coffee. I think the bitterness of that coffee is a perfect way to end your meal. Somehow, after tasting that bitter filter coffee, I feel like I've washed the sin of some of my indulgences away. And I think that's what a coffee at the end of a meal does. It alleviates, lessens the guilt to a certain extent. Well, I've tasted all those dishes for 250 rupees. So that's the thing about meals like these. You can really indulge, overindulge, and it doesn't hurt your pocket too much. Well, I've enjoyed my tiffin experience here. I've tasted a few dishes, and each one of those dishes has been outstanding, right from the Goli Bajji to the Maddur Vade to the Rava Idli, and of course, not to forget that decadent buttery Benne Masala Dosa. And of course, we closed our meal here with that lush ghee laden kesari bhat. And then you look around and you find people happily tucking away into their thindi, into their tiffin, and many of them have been coming here year after year. I've met people today who've come here 20, 30 years in a row, and they swear by the taste, the consistency of the dishes that are served there. I think that's what makes a meal at CTR special. So if you're in Bengaluru and you haven't tried CTR Malleswaram yet, you better make sure you get here and taste some of the fare, especially that Benne Masala Dosa. Don't leave without tasting at least one or two of those crispy, decadent dosas. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating or drinking.
If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the home page. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!